Hey, in this video, I'm gonna give you my top three best bang for your buck supplements and herbs to improve insulin sensitivity. And they're not necessarily the most common ones that you would find. So if you did a Google search and you asked this question, how to improve insulin sensitivity, these three that I'm gonna give you, they're not gonna be the ones that you're gonna find most people recommending. So stay tuned for the rest of this video. Hey, what's up everyone? Eric Bowling here. So look, in today's video, I'm gonna give you my top three best bang for your buck supplements to improve insulin sensitivity. If you don't know what insulin resistance is, I highly suggest you go back to my very first video talking about this topic and explaining it. So, because if you feel a little bit lost, if you don't know why you need to be insulin sensitive, you should definitely watch that video first. But let's go ahead and go straight into this video. My number one recommendation for a supplement that's not commonly prescribed for insulin sensitivity is going to be glycine. Now, glycine is an amino acid, but it's actually one of the body's most important regulators for inflammation in the body. One study that was done actually found that obese individuals in type 2 diabetics had lower glycine when they checked their blood markers. Now, a lot of people will ask, is that correlation not causation? Well, there's another study that showed that when type 2 diabetics or people who were insulin resistant supplemented with glycine, they actually saw improvements in their HbA1c, their fasting glucose levels, and in their insulin markers. So I would say definitely causation. Having low levels of blood glycine can lead to insulin resistance, or it can just affect different things. So think of it more as a domino effect. So if you think that you're insulin resistant, or you want to improve insulin sensitivity, add glycine to your supplementation regimen. Okay, a great way to implement it is in your post-workout drink. So I would suggest starting with just 1 gram and then slowly working your way up, because sometimes it can have quite a diuretic effect to it. So start slow and work your way up. Okay, my second recommendation is known as Salacia, okay, or Salicea. I've heard it pronounced many different ways. If you Google search this one, you're not gonna find much on it. I'm not really sure why this herb is not more, is not popular, but the effects of it are quite amazing in terms of what it can do. It's almost on par with berberine. Okay, so I talked about that in my last video, that berberine, it has a very drastic effect on lowering HbA1c in people. Salacia has very common or similar traits as berberine in terms of what it can do for helping with insulin sensitivity. So that would be my second choice. One study found that when you pair it with vitamin D, it had a greater effect. So not necessarily sure why. I mean, vitamin D can definitely help if a person is deficient, but try it out. Try it with vitamin D, try it without vitamin D, but definitely implement this to improve insulin sensitivity. And my third recommendation is going to be L-carnitine. Now, why L-carnitine? I'm sure a lot of people were thinking chromium, or they were thinking, you know, something else that could help with insulin resistance. Actually, we have to think about why people become insulin resistant in the first place. And I'll get to explaining L-carnitine, but let's first look at insulin resistance. Usually people who are fat will have insulin resistance, because the less muscle mass you have, the more fat you have, the less insulin receptor sites you have, yada, 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 and your body doesn't process insulin as well. So your body starts to become resistant to it. So we know that one of the main culprits is going to be being overweight or having too much fat. So if we can take something that is known to help with lipolysis or fat metabolism, then that's going to be the best bang for your buck in terms of handling insulin resistance. So L-carnitine has been shown to be one of the better supplements out there in terms of metabolizing fat. There's also some very drastic effects that it can have on improving insulin sensitivity. Whether that improvement in insulin sensitivity is just coming from how it metabolizes fat, we don't necessarily know, but the research is pretty clear that it's very beneficial. Everything is like a domino effect in the body when it comes to hormones. So the fatter you are, the more of an enzyme you have called aromatase. And aromatase is basically like a converter. So the more testosterone you have, aromatase comes in, it grabs it, and will convert it into estrogen. Now, why is that important, and how does that relate to insulin? Well, testosterone, is kind of has an inverse relationship with cortisol. Okay, now cortisol is the stress hormone, right? So the lower testosterone you have, the higher cortisol you will have. Now let's link this back up to insulin. The higher cortisol you have, usually the higher insulin you'll have. Now, why is that the case? Well, insulin and cortisol can't necessarily be in the bloodstream at the same time. They kind of work inverse, kind of how testosterone works. So think about it like this. When you're highly stressed out, cortisol rises. You want shitty foods, right? You want carbohydrate-rich foods, you want sugary foods. Why? Why does that happen, right? You were stressed out, someone broke up with you, and you found yourself down in a whole tub of Ben and Jerry's, right? Why does that happen? Well, because insulin, okay, as we get an increase in blood sugar, and as your body starts to produce insulin, cortisol starts to go down, okay? So that's why sometimes we call things comfort foods, or we know that binging on sugary foods is sometimes a stress management tool, which is not good, right? It's not healthy. So as your insulin goes up, cortisol goes down. So now let's bring this full circle back to being fat, okay? The fatter you are, you're kind of causing a domino effect in your body to allow your body into a behavioral pattern that will start to form where you start to crave sugary foods more, okay? So it's kind of like a catch-22, right? You're fat because you crave certain things, and you crave certain things because you're fat. So you kind of catch yourself in a rut or in a pickle, and you kind of get stuck. So managing hormones by managing your food and managing your fat sources is going to be one of the better ways to handle things. Now, obviously training and nutrition, putting yourself in a caloric deficit and making sure you're eating enough protein is going to be the number one way to do all this. But supplementation can help, and bringing this back to L-carnitine, L-carnitine has been shown to be very powerful in metabolizing fat. So if you need that extra little boost, if you need something in addition to what you're doing, or maybe your progress has just halted and you're not necessarily sure why you're not losing fat, supplementing with L-carnitine can be very beneficial. Now, before you run to the store and buy, you know, the cheapest form of L-carnitine, there is something to know about it. There's only one brand that I recommend for L-carnitine, and that's gonna be Jarrow's. Now, I'm not endorsed by Jarrow's, I'm not sponsored by Jarrow's, it's just the only one I recommend. And I recommend their CarnitAll, okay? You can find it at virtually any health food store. So all these things are very important to learn, because while calories and macros are important, something that's as equally important is managing your hormones, okay? Managing insulin, making sure you're not insulin resistant, making sure your blood markers look great is going to be key to living a healthy life, but also making sure you look the best. So if you're in the gym and you're dieting and for some reason you're at a plateau and you know the fat just won't come off, you might want to check into things like measuring HbA1c, checking your fasting glucose, and also checking things like insulin in the body. Okay, so once again, if you're still a little confused on all these topics and you're getting ready to type a comment and asking what does all this mean, please watch my very first video on this topic where I explain insulin and insulin resistance in a little bit more detail, and I talk about more practical ways that you can reverse it, such as what type of diet I recommend, what type of training style I recommend, etc. So make sure that you watch that very first video. Okay, and that's it for this video. These are just three little, what I would call hacks to improve insulin sensitivity, but obviously the thing that's going to help the most is going to be fixing your diet, cleaning it up, and implementing weight training, but these things can definitely help. If you like this video, if it was helpful, please make sure you click that like button, leave a comment. I will respond, and I'm pretty quick on responding to all comments. So if you have a question, please ask it. And once again, please make sure to subscribe. I know I said this last time, but work has been busy, working with clients, working with online clients as the business grows, and obviously at the beginning of the year, it's always busy. So that's kind of where my attention has been. That's why I haven't been pumping out a YouTube video a week. But now that I have everything a little bit more organized, I know I said that the last video, I should be getting back to posting one video a week. And if there's any specific content that you guys would like to see me make, always comment. I definitely want to make videos that people want to see versus videos I want to make. So any questions you guys have, you can either email them or post them in the comments below, and that will be the content that I decide to make. Okay, so until then, I will see you guys next week.